educating patients about antibiotic usage. With all that busy healthcare providers must think about these days, sometimes real communication with the patient falls by the wayside. But there's no question about it, communication plays a key role in good treatment outcomes, especially when it comes to prescribing or not prescribing antibiotics. You might have heard a lot recently about antibiotic resistance, where antibiotics lose their effectiveness in fighting bacterial infections. It is a major public health concern. If we're not careful how we prescribe and use antibiotics now, these 20th century miracle drugs might not be effective in the future. While many of you understand the need for greater stewardship in the outpatient setting, the reality of practice is that sometimes you are put in an awkward position. The patient comes in and may expect antibiotics. You don't have abundant extra time to counsel them. This video is intended to give providers communication strategies to help patients understand antibiotic resistance and why antibiotics aren't always the answer. Say a patient has an upper respiratory infection, likely viral. Here's how a typical provider and patient conversation might go.
Doc, I've had this before. The green mucus, the coughing, the sneezing. I had to take time off work yesterday. Now I'm taking more time off to come see you. Last month when I came to see Dr. Smith for the same problem, she gave me antibiotics. That seemed to take care of it.
Okay, I'll call in a prescription. What pharmacy do you use?
As a society, we are used to taking a pill to cure what ails us. Too often, antibiotics are a quick fix and inappropriately prescribed for viral infections, where they are not effective. If there is a question in your mind, or if you worry the patient might not return or call if they don't get better, you might be tempted to prescribe antibiotics to cover the bases. Let's rewind that conversation and see if the provider could have made the point a little differently.
She gave me an antibiotic, and that seemed to work.
This is likely viral, so antibiotics won't work. You'll just have to wait it out until your immune system naturally fights it, maybe a week or two.
Okay, that likely won't get the result the provider was looking for. No patient wants to hear they'll need to stay home to fight an infection for 2 weeks. If the doctor had expressed empathy for their concerns, briefly explained antibiotic resistance, and shared specific steps in a plan of action, the exchange would probably have gone better. Let's try that again.
She gave me an antibiotic. That seemed to take care of it.
I understand how you're feeling. Several patients have come in with the same concerns this week. The bad news is this is a viral infection, so antibiotics won't cure this illness. But the good news is there are many symptomatic treatments that will help. Here's what you could try. Drink plenty of fluids, get rest, use a cool mist vaporizer, gargle with warm salt water. You may need to let your body use its natural defenses to fight this. Taking antibiotics when they won't work can cause other problems like stomach upset or diarrhea. We're really rethinking the way we prescribe, because antibiotics have been misused for years and are becoming less effective when we really need them. And please remember, if you're not feeling better in a couple of days, I want you to call the office again and we can revisit this plan of action.
You see what the prescriber did there? First, a statement of empathy and understanding of the patient's concern. Then a course of action is outlined to relieve symptoms. Patients respond well to details, not just buy whatever cough syrup and cold medicine you like. Next, a brief lesson on antibiotic resistance and why antibiotics aren't always the answer. Finally, recent medical literature indicates patients want a contingency plan in case they don't feel better in a few days. And guess what? It took about a minute to say it. We timed it. Now you might also get a question like this.
I think I just need the antibiotics. What harm can it do? Can't you just give them to me? It couldn't hurt, could it?
Yes, it could. Antibiotics are a precious resource. If we give you antibiotics for a viral infection and it won't work, that lets superbugs thrive and multiply. We may come to a day when you or a loved one get a serious infection and there is no available medicine to fight it. All because we inappropriately prescribe antibiotics in the past. And the more we are exposed to antibiotics, the more resistant the bugs get. It's important to remember antibiotics are medications. And if you are taking antibiotics and they aren't needed, it can cause you direct harm. Some people have allergic reactions or experience side effects from interactions of other medications that they are taking. Antibiotics can also disrupt your gastrointestinal system and increase your risk of antibiotic-associated diarrhea, including infectious diarrhea caused by Clostridium difficile.
Research indicates there are four key strategies when faced with a patient who may want antibiotics that are not indicated. 1. Review the physical exam findings supporting diagnosis of a cold.
Your lungs sound good. There is no sign of pneumonia. Your throat is red, but it's not a strep infection.
2. State the diagnosis.
What we have here is a bad cold.
3. Give your treatment recommendation. Details are usually welcome.
You can get plenty of rest, drink fluids, take over-the-counter symptom relief, and use a vaporizer.
4. Give a contingency plan.
If this isn't better or becomes worse in a couple of days, I want you to call us back.
What about situations where an antibiotic is called for, like a bacterial infection? Some prescribers choose a broad-spectrum antibiotic when they're not quite sure what the illness is or they fear they will miss some underlying infection. Consider prescribing narrow-spectrum antibiotics targeted to work on a very specific infection.
I'm not really sure what's going on with my pediatric patient. I think I'm just going to give him a Z-Pak and be done with it.
You know, I'd be careful about that. Actually, amoxicillin is a better antibiotic to treat what the patient has while avoiding the unnecessary side effects of a broader spectrum agent.
The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention's Get Smart campaign has many educational brochures, flyers, and a viral prescription pad, which is a takeaway for patients, so if they can't have a prescription, they don't leave the visit empty-handed. Try some out in your waiting room or exam room today. It might just make that conversation about antibiotics a little easier. For materials and more information, go to health.ny.gov or cdc.gov.